1. A Brief History of Forever. At its birth, forever was invented for promise rings, names carved into trees, and photographs. Throughout time, forever has acted as the defining principle of many phrases and ideas popular among adolescents. Best friends forever, together forever, forever and always, forever young. In more recent years, forever, with its cousins always and infinity, has dominated young adult literature. Perks of Being a Wallflower, Fault in Our Stars, and differentiated the internet from the more fleeting IRL, and, one could argue, explained the popularity of the Galaxy print. Nothing lasts forever, of course, but nothing doesn't resonate with a teenager the way forever does, because for better or worse, it's hard to imagine ever not feeling this way, being this person, having this life.
I started Rookie because I didn't see a publication out there that respected teenagers' intelligence in the way I was looking for. At the same time, you know, you don't want to read, like, the junior version of The New Yorker. Like, I want, you know, we have DIYs and makeup stuff and goofy things about relationships, and that's important to me because I don't think, you know, everyone wants to be serious all the time. So, at the same time that we have articles about relationships or self-harm or body image, we also have articles that are just, like, fun DIYs. Or we have photo stories that are just meant to celebrate fashion and expressing yourself in that way. So, to me, having the mix is really important.
Forever is not supposed to be the best time of someone's life, but it is certainly the most forever-y. So I'm not sad because post-forever seems terrible. I'm sad because forever is remarkably peculiar, and I've really enjoyed it, and I will miss it. People have often asked me if this ambition to understand my own teenage existence has lessened its sincerity, made my experiences too self-aware. But it's been quite the opposite. Chris Krauss writes in I Love Dick,
this is the third rookie yearbook because we feel every year like we have just too much good stuff online that it has to live on in some kind of tangible way. We have every month of the website in its third year in print, and each one has a different theme, so then the visual language for each one just like changes very drastically.
This month is basically like Beyonce and Lorde month.
It's really nice for me because I'm a massive hoarder and I get to finally put all of my clothes and trinkets and jewelry and all of that to good use. So like most of the book, when you go through, it's like my clothes or vintage wrapping paper I've collected or what have you. And it gives me an excuse to buy a lot of stuff on Etsy as well. It's really fun piecing it all together.
Wow. Very exciting. Okay. Taking it all in. Very cool, very cool. Election is one of my favorite movies. Tracy Flick is one of my favorite characters ever, and I love Matthew Broderick in that movie, and Chris Klein. Oh, it's like, it all comes flooding back. So I obviously need to take this one.
Determined by a culture at a certain time in history.
Oh, there's one more thing about Tracy I think you should know.
Her pussy gets so wet, you can't believe it.
Don't tell me that. I don't want to know that.
B.
You probably think the worst, that Mr. Novotny was taking horrible advantage of one of his students. But it wasn't like that at all. Our relationship was based on mutual respect and admiration. Since I grew up without a dad, you might assume psychologically I was looking for a father figure. But that had nothing to do with it at all. It was just that Dave was so strong, and he made me feel so safe and protected. It was the first time somebody ever saw the real me. The me that nobody else knows.
Okay, here, get down. Get down.
You once, twice, three times a lady.
Back on my relationship with Mr. Novotny. What I miss most is our talks.
Oh, I love Valerie and her Week of Wonders. Such a good, weird movie.
One of our photographers always says that the best way to go about making something is to see where the void is and try to fill it. So for me, I was nearing the end of middle school and starting high school, and I just felt that there wasn't a publication that really spoke to me as a teenager or as a girl about the things I was interested in and worried about and excited about.